everybody. Thanks for joining me again on another day of our Love Revolution. We're closing in on the end of our 21 days towards creating new habits about how we love people, how we push that outward from us, and kind of all the little nuances that might entail. So today's challenge is kind of a simple one, I think. It might be a challenge for a few people. But I want to think about sharing your enthusiasm as part of this love revolution. I don't know if you've ever been around people that are just really charismatic or have a lot of enthusiasm for something. It's contagious. I mean, you've ever been in a room when some giggles break out and it just keeps spreading. You can't help but laugh when somebody else is laughing. And you know, what really got me is I was watching the newest Kid President, which I am a huge Kid President fan, watching his new video release where he was asked to spread the news for the White House egg roll for children and kind of put it out there about the lottery to get it in part of the festivities around Easter time. And they did a little segment at the end where he was so excited about having been asked to do this, and he couldn't stop dancing, and he's just pumped up, and all you do is giggle and laugh right through it with him. And I thought, you know, it's really sad that as adults, we don't share our enthusiasm enough, because that can change moods and attitudes and create places of happiness and joy for people, which then open up other opportunities to start discussions and finding out what we have common places in. And it just keeps going and going and going, right? So I want to challenge you to think about sharing your enthusiasm. Now, I do want to put a few rules in place. I'm not a big rule person, for those of you that know me. Yes, I do like things in certain order, but that doesn't mean I necessarily am a rule person, except for that I do believe they may be broken. But think about these guidelines when you are sharing your enthusiasm. Make sure you're kind of in the appropriate environment and venue at the time to share your enthusiasm, and think about your topic and the people that you're around. For instance, if you're a guy and you walk into a group of girls, it might not be best to strike up a conversation about your diehard enthusiasm for, say, baseball, for instance. Find the right group of people, find the right topic. But generally speaking, if you have enthusiasm, you have this passion for life or something that you're interested in, or just general excitement because you met somebody or got to talk to somebody, or somebody bought the coffee before you, and they, you know, had paid for your coffee before you even got up there. It's just random act of kindness. And that struck you as, man, I'm so excited today. Share my enthusiasm with you. Do it. It changes people. It changes their day. It changes their moments. It gets them to think differently. It's planting tiny seeds by just sharing. And I think sometimes as adults, we feel really weird and goofy about doing that. That if somehow I'm overexcited, then something might be wrong with me. You know, it's like she having a manic moment, what's going on with her? But share it. It is contagious. People want to know why you're excited. People want to know what's going on. How can you be so happy and positive? Because I make a choice to do it. Every breath, every moment, every time I take a step, it's a choice. It's a series of choices, and all of them, I choose to be positive ones. And you can do it too. So go out. Find people to share your enthusiasm with today. It's okay if they look at you a little funny. Do what I do. Eye roll. It's okay. Do the eye roll. Do something else. Whatever's your thing. And brush it off. Because, hey, why should I hold back on my happiness because you don't get it? You will if you just open yourself up to it. So go out and share it with people today. Have a good one. Oh, baby, you know you made me. So long.